to Word Studies with Dr. Ray Winston, a powerful and in-depth study of the Word of God. Dr. Ray?
Psalm 119:105 says, "Thy words are a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path." Well, welcome to Word Studies. I am Dr. Ray. And as I said before, this is Word Studies. So let me look at my prompter, if you will. Welcome to Word Studies. I am Dr. Ray. And I want to thank God for the opportunity to study with you the ever-living Word of God. Hebrews 4:12 says, "For the Word of God is quick and powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit, and of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart." Welcome again to Word Studies. On this program, we study in depth the words of God. Recently, we have been studying on the pneumaticon. Pneumaticon, of course, is a Greek word for spiritual things, spiritual matters, things of the spirit in particular. We're going to be looking at something that is perhaps off the beaten path, except for this time of the year, the month of October. In about, what, 10, 12 days, 11 days or so, we're going to be, as it were, they're going to be, maybe, some of us are going to be, that is, celebrating a so-called holiday called Halloween. And we're going to look into what Halloween is all about, because many times, if it's a holiday, you know, man, I'm going to celebrate it. You know, I get my day off work, I get this, I get that, I get presents, I get gifts, I get so forth, and it's a holiday, so I can go out and, you know, drink myself a Mai Tai or something like that, and just kick back, take a trip to Las Vegas, wherever, yeah, it's a holiday. Okay, well, that's fine. There's nothing wrong with celebrating holidays, birthdays, and so forth like that. Yes. You know, there are many holidays. Christmas. What's wrong with Christmas? That's the day that Christ was born. Yeah. And so-called, what we call Easter, Resurrection Day, of course, we celebrate that. But some of our Christian holidays, as it were, have been secularized, if you will, for lack of a better word. Sorry, that's a big word, secularized. What does that mean? Secularized means that they become worldly, as it were, yeah? Rather than God being the focus or His Son being the focus, things become the focus. The more things you can get, the more gifts you can get, and so forth like that, and so forth. But we're going to look at a holiday that never has been a Christian holiday. Yes, it's not now, it never has been, and hopefully it never will be, because at one time they tried to make Halloween, yeah, and as a matter of fact, that's the way it got their name in a way, yeah, the Halloween, they tried to make it into a Christian holiday. The day after Halloween was called All Hallows Day. That was November 1st. As a matter of fact, of course, that's the day after October 31st, which is Halloween. Now, there are many things that happen on Halloween that just simply does not happen ordinarily, if you will. You know, people do things. You know, we do all kinds of things. You know, somebody say, well, we sin every day, so what's the problem with Halloween? You're sinning on Halloween. You sin anyway. Yeah. Well, you know, we don't do it that way, though, because Halloween is actually a celebration of death or the celebration of the devil. Now, we're going to look at some history, if you will, of Halloween. Then we're going to go into scripture of people who did, in fact, who were believers, who were followers of God, and they got into the occult, if you will. Yeah. So now let's find out what it is that you perhaps not. Yeah, because many times churches even do this thing. Notice what it says about Halloween. Never has been a holiday and has no life in the place of a Christian or a believer, if you will. History of Halloween. You want to know the history of Halloween? We're going to look at it here in a moment. Notice October 31st is the most important day in the satanic year. It marks the Celtic New Year. Celtics were those, they were from over in Europe, and they were the ones who started Halloween. It didn't start here in this country, thank God, but it did reach this country. Now, of course, it's just as big almost as Christmas, if you will. Notice. It marks the Celtic New Year. It was the ending of the growing season. It became a festival of death. Do you want to celebrate that? I don't think so. On this day, the god of the Celtics was to have called up spirits of the wicked dead who had died during the past year. At the same time, other evil spirits arose and went about the countryside harassing people on October 31st, Halloween. The Celtics expected to be harassed by the ghosts or evil spirits and demons, and it was no fun and games to them. They would light bonfires to guide the spirits to their own town to ward off evil spirits. Can you imagine something like that actually going on? Believe it or not, it's going on today. Are you telling us, Dr. Ray, that it's going on today? That's what I'm saying. It happens today. Notice, if you will, druid. You know what a druid is? Let's find out what a druid is. The Celtics had satanic priests called druids. That's what the priests were called, druids. If you, that name druid by itself sounds kind of weird. I once knew a girl named Druette, and I often wonder, well, where did she get the name Druette from? Perhaps she got it from these druids. I don't know, because her mother, well, I don't need to go into that. Notice, on druids, the Celtics had satanic priests called druids. On October 31st, the druids went from house to house demanding certain foods, and all those who refused were cursed. Can you imagine that? Now, I don't know how you can curse anyone. Unless God allows it, you know, you can't curse a believer or a Christian. Anyway, but you can open yourself up to evil spirits, if you will. Yeah. You can be oppressed, not possessed, but oppressed, if you will, by evil spirits. Notice, the people were tormented by means of magic as they went. The druids carried large turnips, which they had hollowed out and in which they had carved demon faces as charms. Each one was believed to contain the demon spirit and the personality or guided that priest, his little god. In other words, that priest or that druid was his little god. You know that in Egypt, they had their own individual god. As a matter of fact, they also had their own individual gods in Rome, yeah? Or in where the Apostle Paul was, I think it was Rome, yeah? Well, they had these, everybody had their own little god. You know, I got my god, you got your god. You remember when Jonah was swallowed up by the, not swallowed up by the, well, he was swallowed up by the big fish, but before that, the storm came up. God told Jonah what to do. Jonah said, no, I don't want to do it. I'm going the opposite direction. So Jonah went on vacation. Yeah, went on a cruise, as a matter of fact. On the ship, God caused a storm to come up. You know, many times God will cause storms to come up in your life when perhaps, yeah, you're doing the opposite of what he's told you to do. And you know that you know that you know what God wants you to do. And you say, oh, okay, I don't want to do that. I want to do something else. Yeah, that's what Jonah did, remember? And the crew on the ship was wondering, well, why did this big storm coming up? And we didn't have any weather forecast of a storm. Yeah. You know, anytime you say, okay, if the weatherman says there's going to be a storm, it's not going to be a storm. But this storm came out of nowhere, okay? And whose fault was it? With Jonah. So it said all of those on the ship prayed to their own gods, plural. They all had their own individual gods, and they were praying to them. Well, Jonah knew what was going on. He said, Jonah, you know what? Jonah told him, you know, that ain't going to do y'all no good. As a matter of fact, praying to those aren't even real gods, yeah? And he told him what the problem was. I'm the problem. I be the problem. So they threw him overboard. The storm stopped, and everything was fine. Then Jonah went and did what he was supposed to do. Okay. Now, we don't each have, as believers, we've got one God, yeah? His name is Yeshua HaMashiach, or Jesus the Christ. He's the only God. He's the only true God. There are a perhaps many little gods, if you will. But when you read the Bible, you notice that whenever anything concerning God is in there, it's capitalized so that you know you're talking about the only God, the only true God, El Shaddai. Yeah. Okay. The only true God. Notice, divination. If you look at the word divination, somebody said, well, Dr. Ray, aren't you going to get to some scriptures? I am. Yeah. But I give you background. Yeah, you need to know that you know what you are indeed, if you are, yeah, celebrating on the day, October 31st. Notice, divination. Those who practiced fortune-telling and divination found that this was the night that they had the most success. Yeah. And there's somebody else who used to come on television. I don't know whether she comes on TV again. Her name is Elvira. You ever hear of Elvira? Well, she may still be coming on television, but she comes on only during the Halloween season. Does Elvira? She calls herself a witch, if you will. Yeah. Now, somebody said to me, well, Dr. Ray, are there such things as witches, or the male part of that is called wombat, or so I can't remember the exact name of the male part of it, or witches. Could there be a witch? You know, like witches ride brooms and so forth like that. Yeah. Well, now, I'm not laughing at it in disbelief, because there are some people who believe in it, yes. And, of course, you can kind of, if you believe in something, you can almost make it come true, yeah. For you, notice, they call upon Satan to bless their efforts. One form of divination was to put apples in a tub in the barn for them. Did you ever do that? I remember doing that when I was a kid. I was, I don't know, well, I was 7 years old, 8 years old, 9 years old. I don't know how old I was. But they put apples in a tub and we bought the apples. And I didn't know the significance of it then. You know, and what does an 8 year old know? You know, you're just then beginning to trying to figure out the difference in the sexes. Yeah. So what do you know about a tub bobbing up and down in a tub with apples in it? I just wanted to eat the apple. Yeah. But you had to go in that tub and you couldn't use your teeth. You know, you couldn't bite it. You could bite into it. It's floating. How are you going to bite something that's floating? Yeah. Okay. That's a form, as it were, of divination. I'm sure that the people that were around there at the time who were having the party or whatever it was not aware of the significance of it. Notice what it says, though. The one who first successfully came up with one apple without putting them in his teeth was to have good luck throughout the year. They would then peel the apples, throw the peel over their shoulders, and then quickly look around. They expected to see a vision of an apparition of the one they were to marry. Now, my wife didn't even live in the same country. No, well, she lived in the same country, but not in the same state. So I'm going to look around and get a vision of her. Okay. Well, okay, if it was a vision, I suppose I could have done that. I don't ever remember doing that, throw apples or peelings over my shoulder. We didn't get to that part of it. Notice, you just brought the apple up, it's your apple, you can eat it. Notice, sacrifices. Have you ever sacrificed it? You don't think that, well, sacrifices of animals and so forth like that. Believe it or not, one of our biblical believers was exposed to human sacrifice. Does anybody know who that was? You can call me and tell me later. You don't have to tell me right now. I'll tell you in a moment who it was that was exposed to human sacrifices, if you will. Notice. Now, you might think a human sacrifice is something that's totally occultish, yeah, or of the devil, if you will. But as Sammy Davis Jr. would say, that ain't necessarily so. However, notice what we're going to look at is of the devil. Notice, these things happen, sacrifices, several centuries before Christ. Sacrifices were made to the god, especially to the god Samhain. There was a god named Samhain. I don't know how you get the name Samhain. What kind of name is that? What kind of language is that, Samhain? Is it Chinese or something? Sacrifices all the way from vegetable to human were offered. This went on and on and on and on for some period of the world and still goes on, guess what? Today. Yeah, there are people who are preparing, as it were, right now, yes, to do sacrifices on Halloween. Many times they find dead animals, dead whatever. That's because sacrifices is going on. Haven't found, as far as I know, a human that was sacrificed in this country, but I suppose it may have happened, yes, and could happen. Notice. 8th century. You remember the 8th century? I mean, I had a dream. When did I have that dream? I think it was last night. Yeah, I dreamed I was in the 30. No, I was in the 3006. Yeah. Now, okay. You know, when you have a dream, you don't know. You just, whatever the dream puts out, it's there. Yeah. And I was in 3006. That's almost 1,000 years from now. And I was trying to tell those people about the new things that we had. Yeah. Now, they were looking at me like I was crazy. You know, those things are, that's old fashioned, if you will. Yeah. Cell phones and so forth like that. We don't need that stuff anymore. Electric lights, oh, forget that, man. We don't need that. In 3006. Yeah. Now, somebody asked me about, what does that mean, Doctor? I have no clue, if you will, what that means. But I thought then, well, okay, I must have gone into the wrong century. You know, ever heard of time travel? Yeah. Yeah. Okay. I think there was a guy named Tesla. You ever hear of Tesla? Tesla invented a machine that made his wife disappear. Yeah, you can read it on, you can look it up online. Yeah, if you think that I'm just making stuff up. No, Tesla was a real person. He was the one who is the reason why we have AC lighting rather than DC lighting in our lighting system. Yeah. Or Edison. I know everybody knows who Edison was. Edison wanted to be DC, and no. Tesla said, no, we need to AC. So Tesla won out, but who got credit for it? Edison did. But anyway, notice the 8th century, not the 3006 would be I can't even get those centuries together. Notice, these things happened several centuries before Christ. That was sacrifices. Notice the 8th century. In the 8th century, the Pope, in an effort to get the people to quit the festival of Samhain, invented All Saints Day, November 1st. All Saints Day. That's the day after Halloween. This was an attempt to get the people to turn away from their horrible observances of Samhain and celebrate All Saints Day. Okay. All Saints Day was intended to honor the martyrs of the Roman persecution. It did not work. You cannot mix the things of God with the things of the devil. Yeah? No, even God won't let you do that. Yeah, notice. Middle Ages. Have you ever heard of the Middle Ages? I used to order the Middle Ages. You know, Middle Ages of what? You know, what is that? 28 BC or something or other like that? Notice, we're going to look and see what the Middle Ages are. In the Middle Ages, there was a great revival of satanic practices and witchcraft and magic like there is today. Okay. During this time, the belief developed that witches traveled on broomsticks to the Black Sabbath to worship Satan on October 31st. Okay. They were guided by spirits in the form of black cats. The Druids worshiped cats, believing them to be reincarnated evil spirits. Now, you might think that, well, that can't happen today, Dr. Ray. Well, I got news for you. Okay. It did. When I was, I don't know how old I was then, I'm guessing 10. Or something or other, yeah? And there was a guy who was older than me. I guess he was, 15, 16 or something or other like that. Anyway, we were walking to the store, if you will, and a black cat went across the street in front of us. Well, this guy said, no, I can't walk down this street. I have to go around, you know, I can't cross the path of a black cat because that's bad luck. Have you heard of if you walk across the path of a black cat, then that's bad luck? Yeah. And I looked at him and said, crazy man. You know, I'm not going all the way. I'm not going a mile out of the way because of a black cat. How do I know the cat didn't cross there before you saw him? Yeah. Okay. So that goes to show you that people who practice that sort of thing, it still happens today. Yes. So. Okay, it happens today. During this time, the belief developed that witches travel on broomsticks. I've seen that on television, you know, in cartoons and so forth, like that with a witch riding a broomstick. There was a movie, I think, that they made about this witch. I don't know what the actress's name was. Yeah. Okay, they were guided by spirits in the form of black cats. Okay, notice, church, how do we get involved in it, you might say? So, Dr. Ray, you're saying, okay, the church is involved in Halloween and witchcraft and divination and so forth like that? Yes, it is. There are some, not I wouldn't say many, I don't know how many. There are some churches who set up in their fellowship halls places where the babies, the children in the church can celebrate Halloween, believe it or not. Yeah, it happened. Notice what this is. This festival of death has survived all the efforts of the church to stamp it out. The church is joining the opposition by celebrating this festival. The devil has been very successful in invading Christian holidays like Christmas and Easter, providing counterfeits for the real thing. Halloween is different. It has always been satanic. He has deluded the Christians into celebrating his festival. Can you imagine setting up this stuff in your church? Notice, I'm going to go to scriptures in a moment, yeah? Notice what he says. All Saints Day became All Hallows Day. Hallow means holy. Sacred, you know, hallowed be thy name. You got it? Okay. Hallow means holy or sacred. October 31st is the evening before All Hallows Day and came to be called in the Western world All Hallows Evening and then Hallows In and eventually Halloween. Okay. Okay. Finally, the word was reduced to the way we have it today, Halloween. Okay. That's where the name came from. And even if it is called All Hallows Evening, it has nothing to do with Christian faith and never did. Yeah. Because some people say, okay, well, that was handed down. I told you. Didn't I say something about the fact of the matter is that we're going to get to scriptures in a moment? We're going to be there in a moment. Yeah, notice. Modern Halloween. What I was going to say to you is that somebody practiced or sacrifices. Yeah. Do you know what his name is? Let me rephrase that. He was exposed to human sacrifice. Now, I'm saying that he did the human sacrifices, but he's a biblical person that was exposed to human sacrifices. His name was Abram. Okay. Now, you might wonder, oh, you're talking about Abraham, Dr. Ray? Yeah, I'm talking about Abraham. God changed his name from Abram to Abraham. Well, when he was Abram, right? The place that he came from. I can't remember the name of that little town that Abram came from. But there, they practiced human sacrifices. Now, somebody might say, well, why did you bring that up, Dr. Ray? Because it's a matter of the fact is that Abraham, it might have been changed to Abraham by that time, was going to sacrifice, human sacrifice, his own son. Okay. Okay. Why was he going to do that, Dr. Ray? Why were you going to do that? You know, isn't that against God? Something of that nature? Well, the fact of the matter is, no, it was not against God. Yeah. He was going to sacrifice his son. Who was Abraham's son? His name was Isaac. Yeah. And he took Isaac out with the intention, because God had told him, take him out and to sacrifice him. Yeah. So he was going to sacrifice. Now, if Abram had not been exposed some kind of way to human sacrifice, perhaps he might have fought against God. Yeah. Can you imagine fighting against God? You've lost. Yeah. Remember when, Sonny Liston, I believe, started fighting with a boxer? And everybody thought that, oh, he's going to kill Muhammad Ali. I mean, his name was Cassius Clay at the time. He's going to kill him. And I was thinking then that Cassius Clay, even though people thought he was a fake and for whatever, I thought, this was my own personal thought, that he was going to win the fight against Sonny Liston. Sonny Liston was like fighting against a bear. Did you ever fight a bear? Yeah, that's what it's like. You know, a bear wins. You know, you ain't got a chance against a bear. And that's what everybody thought about Sonny Liston and Cassius Clay. And I said, I ought to go bet all of my money and take all my money out of the bank and bet on Cassius Clay. I didn't do that. Yeah, I'm not a gambler. Notice, if you will, modern Halloween. Now, let's look at the present day celebration of Halloween. Isn't the whole theme of one of darkness, death, fear, threats, destruction, and evil? There are witches, broomsticks, bats, owls, ghosts. What else could there be? Yeah. And demons and witches and so forth, ghouls, all of these things are a part of Halloween. Notice. We don't use turnips anymore. What do we use? Everybody knows what we use. They're pumpkins, right? You can go all over the city and you'll find all these pumpkin patch or places where they set up there. And guess who has to go to the pumpkin patch? Kids do. Yeah, the kids they will drive you to drink, I suppose, if you don't take them to the pumpkin patch. Well, they can get a pumpkin and so forth and carve out eyes and so forth like that. Ouija board. You know what an Ouija board is? Seances. All those different things are part of Halloween. Okay. You say, we don't take it seriously, right? It's just fun. Yeah, the devil does. The devil knows that you're celebrating him when you celebrate Halloween. Yeah, God does. Do you think God wants you to celebrate something that is in opposition to what the Bible says? Yeah. Okay, notice then, scriptures. Now, there are several scriptures that talk about God not wanting us to be involved in this stuff. In your Bible, you can turn to the book of Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy chapter 18, as a matter of fact. Now, let me see, where am I supposed to start at with Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 9? Why don't we start reading at verse 9 for the sake of time, okay? Let's start reading at verse 9. Notice what it says at verse 9. I think I did something to my microphone. I need to stop that, don't I? Because I don't want your ears to get messed up. You can't hear then, can you? Notice. First time. This is Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 9. Notice. When you come into the land which the Lord your God is giving you, you shall not, notice, underline the word not, learn to follow the abominations of those nations. They shall not be found among you, anyone who makes his son or his daughter pass through the fire. Somebody asked me once, well, what does it mean to pass through the fire, Dr. A? Well, it's a form of witchcraft, if you will. A form of witchcraft is to pass through the fire. They practice. It's one of these days we're going to get in passing through the fire in depth. Notice what the next verse says right now. Notice, pass through the fire. I stopped on pass through the fire. Did you get through the fire? Or one who practices witchcraft, or a soothsayer, or one who interprets omens, or a sorcerer. Yeah. Now, you know, all of this has to do with Halloween. Look up Elvira on your cell phone. I know some of you are too young to know about Elvira, because Elvira has probably been around for 50 years or more, maybe longer than that. Notice. Okay. I'm trying to keep that ping away. You shall, where am I? One of you who conjures up spells, or a medium, or a spiritist, or one who calls up the dead. Now, I could stop right there, because there is a whole scripture on one who calls up the dead. Now, let me ask you a question. Do you believe it is possible, as a matter of fact, to call up the dead? I'm talking about somebody who's dead. I don't mean that they died day before yesterday or something like that. Yeah. I mean, somebody who's been dead 50 years or whatever. Yeah. A long period of time. Anyway, is it possible then to call up the dead? Well, we've had these people on TV. They call themselves spiritists or whatever they call themselves. They conduct seances, if you will. Yeah. Now, God says, don't do that stuff. Right? So why would you want to do what God said don't do? Yeah. You know that's going to get you into trouble. Read Deuteronomy chapter 28. You know it's going to get you into trouble if you disobey God. Yeah. The very first people in the world who disobeyed God, yeah, got us in all this trouble that we're in now. Right? Yeah. So what trouble are you talking about, Dr. Ray? Well, we're all sinners. Yeah. Saved by the grace of God through faith in his son, Yeshua Jesus. Yes. Otherwise, you're on your way to where? You're on your way to hell. Yeah. Somebody said, okay, then I'll go to hell. Do I ever get out of hell, Dr. Ray? That's a good question. And the answer is yes. You get out of hell. Yeah. Then you go to what is called by the Bible, the white throne judgment. You can find that in the book of Revelation, chapters 2, 3, 4. Yeah. The white throne judgment. Okay? You got out of hell. It's not hot anymore. Yeah? You're out of hell. You've been there for I don't know how long, but you got out. Okay? Now you're standing before the white throne judgment. And you think, okay, everything's fine. Yeah? It's white, isn't it? Doesn't that mean righteousness or something or other like that? No. Not this white throne judgment. You stand before the white throne judgment, and then God is going to tell you all the things that you did wrong, right? In other words, when you go to hell, you're going to say, throw me in hell. I deserve to be in hell for what stuff I did. And for the fact of the matter is, that won't get you into hell. All those bad things that you did won't get you into hell. No, there's only one thing that can get you into hell, right? Rejecting Yeshua Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Not becoming born again. Not becoming born from above. Not becoming a new creation in Christ Jesus. That will get you into hell. Not because you shot somebody in the back and then hid the gun behind you and got away with it for 55 years. Not because you blew up a church in Alabama and killed three or four or five black girls. Yeah, that won't get you into hell. What will get you into hell is rejecting Yeshua Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Yes? Now, somebody said, well, can Hitler repent, Dr. Ray? Somebody asked me that question. Well, can Hitler repent? I mean, after all, he tried to kill the whole nation of Israel. Yeah? Didn't he? Yeah. He didn't accomplish it. Yeah, but he killed a lot of people. I don't know how it's 2.5 million or something or other like that. Jews, yeah, that would get. But now, could he have, might be a better way of phrase for that, could Hitler have repented had he chosen to? All right. Now, the answer, of course, is yes. You know what? We're going to get into more of this next time, because I'm out of time.
Has been a blessing to you and your your family or has helped you in any way, please feel free to write to us and pray for us. Remember also, we need and appreciate your financial support. Please send your financial gifts and love offerings to Dr. Ray Winston at P.O. Box 1173, Culver City, California, 90232. That's Dr. Ray Winston, P.O. Box 1173, Culver City, California, 90232. You also may call Dr. Ray at area code 310-559-8320 or 800-747-8320. Remember also, God loves a cheerful giver.